Hey everybody, it's Dick here. This summer I had the chance to go on a tour of the United States in New England, New York, and some of the Mid-Atlantic. And one of my favorite stops was the Four Aces Diner in West Lebanon, New Hampshire. It's in an odd location just past the river up on a hill. It's tucked behind in a little side road. You could pass it if you weren't looking for it or if you didn't spot the line of people outside on the weekends. The red clapboard house style architecture hides the traditional and original 1952 Worcester diner car number 837. Now the term diner is thrown around with a bit of casualness and I'd say irreverence. And people think that just by putting a bit of neon and a bit of a shiny aluminum and the word diner, you can have a authentic 1950s-ish diner. I blame movies like Grease. It's that Hollywood set designer aesthetic that makes restaurateurs think that they can recreate something as characterful as a diner with just a bit of eye candy. The Greek diners in New Jersey, just outside of New York City, are quintessential diners. The menus as thick as the Bible, with as eclectic and varied dishes as a classic Reuben sandwich or steak and eggs. Chicken Caesar salads, chicken cordon bleu, and of course pancakes, waffles, and a slice of pie. And if you're anywhere near Maine, you can get a glass of swill called Moxie. So when I see a diner, I'm a bit skeptical, but when I see a diner like this, and I walk inside and smell the food, and I see the locals, and I see the iron pants, aged waitresses with big smiles on their face, but a chip on their shoulders, I know I'm in the right place. The family-run diner in America is as endangered a species as the spotted owl. Corporate interests and big mega conglomerates will have a diner, an Italian restaurant, a bistro, and any other style of restaurant next to each other down the high street, and you think that they're all run by different companies, but they're all supplied by the same food distributor, and they're all run by some corporate lackey on one of the coasts in a high-rise building. The tchotchke found in the country-style or diner-style restaurants in these corporate places are inauthentic, and actually there's big companies now that sell vintage-styled tchotchke to put inside your restaurants and pin to your walls. The tchotchke in the Four Aces Diner is authentic and collected over time, and you can see it by the age of the items, the garage sale aesthetic, and the layer of dust. And I appreciate all of that. I have a rule about diners and ice cream dairy bars. Eat where the fatties eat. Some of the most discerning people with the most discerning palates I know are the size of houses. So if you're looking for a diner, look for the fatties.
All right, then you're right in front of the hot sauce. I'm gonna grab some more water.
You just made my day.
Oh, awesome.
Holy crap.
Holy crap indeed.
There really isn't much more to say. If you find yourself at the foot of the White Mountains in New Hampshire near White River Junction or Hanover, look out for the Four Aces Diner and enjoy yourself. I will be going back just so I can have another pass at those pancakes.
Will Dad fall asleep and crash the car?
Don't shake it.
Yes, definitely.